Bobcat, now that you're here, I need you to test something for me. If you scroll down a little bit, if you're on your computer, can you hold on? Let me just pull this up. Let me pull up my incognito window here for a sec. Can you test and see if this is online for you, the sound alerts thing? Because like if I go down, it says it's offline. I need to just check if that's a me thing because I'm not logged in here because this is just a backup thing or if it's offline, then that's a problem because I don't want it to be offline because I actually want to be able to use it. Because if it's offline, I'd like to fix that, like ASAP. I can't do this though. Excuse me. I wonder, can I, I'm gonna run a test alert, see if that does anything. I realize I probably should have done this before I started, but, I figured that would be a fun time to, I figured it'd be a fun thing to show. Here, let me just do that. So I can have this open on my other. It is, in fact, here. Okay, it's there. Just want to lock that, make sure. Okay, it looks like it says that everything's fine. Just test one. I can do test alerts, right? Let's do this one. Oh, okay. So, yeah, it does work. Woo! It says it's online. Yay! All right, cool. That's one of them. I can do a few more. I can show you a couple of the other ones I have. I have this one. Nope. Yeah, that's the one. The honk from Untitled Goose Game, because I like that one. Oh yeah. I had a bad day, and then Mandy Rose lost the NXT Women's Championship, and Carlos Correa signed with the Giants, and everything was just fine. Then I'm gonna do this one too. I like this one. I thought it was longer. Okay, so yeah. If I may, I'll just post this. I'm not upset about Korea. I don't care. It's fucking awesome. I am happy. We made a splash. We don't do that. So yeah, if you want to do this, if you have extra bits, this is just right here. I'm gonna hint right now. This one is loud as hell. It's so loud. So like, it might blow my eardrums out. Just saying, that's why it's so expensive. But like, yeah, it's loud. So just so you know, figured there would be some people who would like to know that. I don't care.
I don't care.
All right, what other good ones are there? Oh, this one. I'll do like the one of them that's over 150. It's this one.
Wah, wah, wah.
Yeah, I feel like people would like that one. In the event I ever get someone who's willing to part ways with their bits, then it should be a fun one. Okay. So now for what I'm actually here for. Let's play some. Let's do some fucking good wrestling.
Okay.
So where we left off, not quite sure. Just after Uglies by the Bay, where we made a good amount of money. Where is my... There they are. I haven't played this game in fucking ages. I recognize I need to start doing that. I need to start playing this game more off camera. And I think I will do that. It's just all a matter of when, not if. Let me just do this so I'm not tempted to look at the other one. Yeah, I know. I was happy you guys took Josh Bell away from the Padres. Okay, so we were off in a good spot. I was certain that this would have gotten me more money, but apparently not. Okay. Now I must continue with this show. I know if it's only been 5 days since I played this last, it feels like an eternity. All I know is that in the time that it's been since I've played this game, I recognize that I need to clean my keyboard because my, because the T key sometimes does the thing where it, like, of course, now that I mention it, it's not going to happen. The T key now does that thing where, one of those things where it's like, where it'll input two of the character whenever I hit it, so... Nah, never mind. It's not important. Oh, I think that sucks about having that on, about having the sound alerts thing on, is that I can't, like, listen to music while I do this anymore. Because, like, it'll come through, and that's DMCA, and I don't want to deal with that, so. I won't. And then let's just get Kratos's title match out of the way. Fun time. It's like another one of those destined to do this forever kind of things. Yeah, let's go. Figured. Cool. Now that just, okay. Lost interest. All right, so apparently I just suck now. Wow, not even a, wow. Okay. Still at 3.3 though. Still whooping NXT UK. Wow. Just one, hey. Nem wants to work with Fatu. I can do that next week. Congratulations. You've now just sorted out my main event next week. It's not going to be a title match. I just want it to happen. give him 15 minutes. Okay. Works for me. Oh, also another thing. Another thing I realized I forgot to tell you. I was trying to do a little tomfoolery and screw around with the random events code a little bit more and, like, adding my own stuff. And I kind of botched it. So, I had to reset the code and all my, custom stuff is, all my custom values and shit are gone. So, everything's back to the way that it was before I started fucking with it. So, and I just haven't gotten around to changing it again, so... It's fine. It's what it is. It is what it is now. It's fine. What can you do? I mean, the game still runs fine. But, I just need to... I just need to, figure out where I'm going wrong with that, and then, I just need to figure out where I'm going wrong with that, and then I'll, one of these days I'll be able to do it. One of these days. I don't know when exactly, but, like, when I learn the language a little bit better, and I kind of am able to see what I'm doing wrong a little bit more, I'll get closer, and I'll be able to do that. Something like that. Yeah, let's go with that. I promise you that was not me. I mean, I could promise you that wasn't me all I want to, but how many people actually believe me? Not a lot of them, that's for sure. Yeah, not a whole lot of people believe me when I say that it's not, that it was not my doing. So, I mean, it's whatever, it's fine. My fake tweet game was on fucking point, though. You'll see when you get back to the... Yeah. You'll see when we get back to, You'll see when we get back to, when you get back to the server, whenever that is. You'll see when you get back to the server. I got a couple messages that were pinned, but were since... removed, where I did a couple of funny fake tweets. So, I think that was those are some good ones, honestly. Okay, so, let me just keep tabs on these. Good to go there. Figure out what I'm doing. I gotta give my main event lady some stuff to do. No, let's do that instead. I haven't used Grim in a while. I also haven't used Marco Stunt in a while. Let's let Simon Grimm have that. I haven't used Rocky Romero for a match that wasn't with Timmy Thatcher in a while. So let's go with... have we run this before? We might have. We also might not have. Excuse me. Probably not. Personally, I think they're good, but like I don't think they're that good. I think I'll give the women the main event this week. Yeah, exactly. Why are we watching Chuck Taylor? I can't stand Chuck Taylor. Fuck you, Chuck Taylor. Oh, man. Also, Alex and I had a fucking blast watching... the new, like, watching NL stream a couple days ago. They had a Christmas-themed stream. So it was good. That's messed up. Yeah, I kind of figured. Yeah, sold out the venue. Let's go. We're able to sell out 10K seaters. 3.3 mil for that episode. Yeah, he's... it's good stuff. Right, there's one more thing I forgot to open. Where is it? Not here. Where is it? There it is. I need to have my Excel document open just in case I gotta do some math or some shit. That was how much I made the last pay-per-view. Alright, let's just, we'll do that for now. With TV deals and written contracts and shit, that's about as much profit as I'm making this month. It's a lot of money. Yeah, just in case I need to do quick maths, I have that doc ready. I have about 36K tied up in written contracts right now. Actually, I think there's a better way I can do that. There's a better way I can do this. Nope. Stop it. Okay. Okay, I think I'm going to do this. I'm going to do it this way. Okay. Just all of that. This will be... it's so... oh, if we're on an ad break, then I probably shouldn't explain it until it's over. So it's so I can keep better track of who to my roster. I can't sort by, can I sort, filter? I can't sort by, yeah, I can't actually. Oh yeah, I can't. No, that doesn't work. Okay. I'll have to just manually go through. I know Athena's on a deal. I know, I think the three people on deals for me, I know Athena's there, and O'Bailey's on one of those deals. I know Nixon's on one of those deals. I think it's just those three, but I'm not sure. Is it just those three? Hold on, let me check the DB. Is it just those three? It is, in fact, no, and me. It's also me. I don't think they do. I don't think they do. You'll have to tell them. So, I am going to do this now. We're going to have Bailey up here. 25,200. I mean, order doesn't really matter. I'm only making $50. Yeah. You're probably going to have to tell him about that. Okay. So my idea here is I'm going to... Excuse me. I'm going to have this list now. So if I sign anybody to another deal, like, for example, if I sign someone like a Speedball Mike Bailey. No, just fucking, it doesn't really matter. So if I sign like a Mike Bailey to a 2K deal or something, it'll automatically update so I don't have to keep doing it manually. This is what happens when you learn the tricks of the trade with Excel and you like learn how to use it. You're able to do shit like that. It's not really that difficult, but it doesn't matter. Anyway, so I mean, I could probably get away with giving like a lot more people written contracts. But at the same time, it's like I don't want to steal anybody away from any other promotion. But at the same time, I'm doing really well for myself, so like it's not my fault. Sucks to suck is basically what I'm trying to say. Let me just make sure we're all balanced here. We are. The only person who's not... The only one that doesn't have a counter is me, but I am a personality, so therefore I don't count. Other than that, I mean, I think we're good. Yeah, like, for example, a guy like Brody King, I don't really want to sign away from everybody else because... He currently, like, runs the NWA right now. So, like, I don't really want to snipe him away. But someone like Brandi Loren, I don't really care. I can absolutely snipe these two away from Impact if I wanted to. I could snipe Bandito away from PWG. Athena's already mine. Like, okay, Jordynne Grace is still the Digital Media Impact Champion, so, like... I'll let her stay. So like if they've got belts at oh god, we're starting on this again already. Really? I mean, I get that. Okay. So guys that aren't fucking of course you are. You son of a bitch. Like guys that aren't tied up to other contracts that like don't have belts. Except for Willow, probably, honestly. They're probably guys that I wouldn't mind, like, signing away. Why are you the Women of Honor World Champ? Fucking eh. I mean, I've had. Oh, the Kira Hogan thing. Yeah. Kira Hogan has had the held the AEW belt for like a couple of years, which like, why? But I'm thinking, it's just like. Like, I can absolutely, like, given the books here, I can absolutely stand to give a little, to give out some written contracts and be like, yeah, let's run this ship a little bit tighter. Like, let's make it so that doesn't happen. Again, like for instance, my main event guys, with the exception, really, of Brody King, because he has all the NWA belts, and I don't really want to fuck over the NWA that much. So like guys like Rocky Romero, Will Hobbs, Timothy Thatcher, I could probably all sign right now if I want to. Should I actually? Depends on how much they'd want, really. Okay, I think Rocky Romero's with New Japan as well. I think Thatcher's the only one who's, like, exclusively mine. He is. Timothy Thatcher's the only one who's exclusively mine out of all three of them. So. Oh, no, not Willow. Hobbs is currently with All Elite Wrestling because, of course. Other than that, no, I think Thatcher's the only one that's actually mine, so what would I have? 11K. Ooh, that's something. What about Hobbs? Oh, God, I can't pay Hobbs. I can't pay Hobbs that much. Sorry, I love him. I can't pay him that much. That's a lot of eggs. There's a lot of eggs in that basket. What about Rocky Romero? 7K for Rocky Romero, huh? Fucking hell. He's a upper mid card face right now, yeah? He's a main event face right now. Yeah, I can't justify Fatu being a good guy. I just can't. But 7K for Rocky Romero though. I mean, if he's willing to take the knock. Down to mid card, I'm willing to. I'm willing to knock him down to the mid card and move like a Bandito up and a Ryan Nemeth up, just because I want Ryan Nemeth to be main eventer at some point. But at the same time, it's like, no, he's fine where he is. I like him being a main event guy. Excuse me. You know what? I think I will pay Rocky Romero. I'll pay Rocky Romero of all people. Paid for by the company. How much would it? It'd bring me up an extra $2,100. Yeah, I'll pay for the travel expenses that I don't even need to pay for. We'll keep you up in the main event. I'll sign him on for a year. Up to this point. Other than that, I think that's fine. $40 million doesn't make a ton. Like, we could survive, yeah, but, like, it just. We could. If we re-sign the TV contract, like, when we. We'll revisit it when we renegotiate TV deal, when we renegotiate the network contracts. As soon as I get that done, we'll, as soon as we get that done, I'll probably sign him then. Okay, so. There we go. We love more merch money! Woo! There. I'm always going to be at the bottom of this. I'm always going to be at the bottom of this. I'll only pay myself 50. I'll pay myself 50 bucks a month. I'll pay myself $50. $50 legitimately. We're just trying to pretend like the rest of this bank, the rest of this bank doesn't also belong to me. In about 3 years of this wrestling company, I've made at least over $30 million. The IRS hates me, bruh. Okay. What are we gonna do for this next show? Oh, we can get that away. Oh, I can book myself in a match. Right here. I mean, I can't do it. I have 40 wrestling skill. I can do it, but like, I don't really want to. I am an interviewer. That is all. That is what I am. Let's give Brandon Cutler a match against Ryan Nemeth. 10 minutes. You know, 10 minutes. Do your thing. And we'll do Roxanne versus new NXT Women's Champion Roxanne, let it be said. Yes, I am gonna call back to that a lot. Every time she comes up, I'm just like, yep, NXT Women's Champion. Gotta say it. Because it makes me very happy. We're revisiting the spot under the desk. Okay, we'll do that next week. We'll do that next week. Give him 5 minutes. Then I think I said I was going to let Bailey do something. Yeah, I'll make Bailey do something. We'll have Bailey go up against Jordynne Grace in a match that I genuinely think would be good. We'll celebrate Rocky Romero in his now like fully guaranteed contract and his guaranteed contract now. We're doing that, of course he's only at 66. I hate you. I need a guy who's at 70 that isn't named Timothy Thatcher, because it's another, like, destined to do this forever kind of rivalry. Fuck it! That's what, you know what? You know what? I'm doing it. Storylines. It's gonna be called Destined to Do This Forever. Yep. Even though it's basically just going to be a why the hell not, I'm doing this just so say I can do it. Okay, Romero versus Thatcher's now in. It's not really building up to anything in particular. I haven't had Rick Knox ref a match yet. Not today. Let's do Speedball and JTG, because why the hell not? And we'll go 13 minutes for no reason other than I want to. And yeah, let's go with that. It could build into something, but it probably won't. Nice. Star and a half. Good job, guys. Oh, fuck off. Crowds are a moment. Oh, they just don't like good wrestling. Well, they're impatient, like my mom. They're impatient, like my mom. So you got, my mom says she's got her for like 8 minutes before she gets bored. Hey, Jordan! You're defending the title again! JTG ask this time. So yeah, so we were going to do Roxy versus Athena this week. NXT Women's Champion Roxanne versus Athena this week. Works for me. Works for me. Every time. I have to. I have to say it. Bet. Got you, sweetie. Oh, man. Damn, I can't do these. I can't do these the same week. I have to I have to have one be the next week. We'll let since JTG asked me first, we'll let JTG go first with his 15 minutes. Is JTG good enough for a steal the show? Is he? 65. No, he's not. Okay. We'll let JTG go first. So we're gonna do Athena versus now current NXT Women's Champion Roxanne Perez. Then we'll do. I haven't had Hobbs on the show in a while. We'll do Hobbs versus Lee, because that should be a fun time. And then we'll do, just as another, we'll actually have the champion in action this week against AR Fox, because I haven't used him in a while. I'm going to do another one of those interviews where it's like, hey, congratulations, you're defending your championship again. I was like, you're defending your title again. Like, does this bother you that I keep doing this? Like, does it bother you that I keep doing this? It was a requested signing. I think by Athena asked me to sign him. It was the first time I'd ever seen somebody do that. So, yeah, that's what I thought. Lost interest, 78%. Seemed to enjoy it. Roxanne wins. Hey. On their feet for Hobbs versus Moriarty. Like that, 4.5 stars. And Jordynne Grace successfully retains. Again, you can't say she's not a fighting champion, because holy shit, she is. All right. That's JTG. We sold out the building. And now Nixon is going to be going up against Jordynne Grace. This week, everybody wants to be working with Jordynne Grace now. Damn. Oh, somebody's approaching me. I can do that. I can do that. I can very much do that. I'll probably knock out two birds with one stone on this next show then. Thanks for booking like fucking at least half the show for me, guys. Woo. Nixon Newell and Jordynne Grace and then Hobbs and Brody King. Yeah, fucking, I will absolutely do that. That's at least like 30 minutes of the show right there. If not more. If not more, at least. I could probably get away with having I can probably have Hobbs and Brody King go for like 20 if I wanted to. Let me just go ahead and make sure that I can do this. Jordynne Grace, 74 and 79. Newell at 77 and 85. Yes, I can do that. I can get away with 20 if I wanted to. Let's do then Brody King versus a Mr. William Hobbs. And I will have them go for 20 minutes. Boom. There you go. That's this week. Other than that, I mean, then we'll have, we'll run, I mean, the reason why I kind of like having, Jordynne Grace have this title is because I saw that, she has, hold on, let me just go. into the database so I can show you here. Wait, why would I go to... Still can't spell over here. She's got something in her personal. She loves intergender wrestling, so she gets boosts when she works intergender matches. So, like, I like having that. I like having that extra boost. But, I mean, yeah, I do get that. She's been holding this belt for a long goddamn time. So, I think for the last little bit, let's run Masters, because I haven't used him in a while, versus Ace Austin. Some nice heel-on-heel action. Why the hell not? One more match. We'll have Bandido take on Rocky Romero, because why the hell not? For only 10 minutes, it feels wrong, but, like, we gotta open the show. We gotta open the show somehow. Okay. Let's hope we booked a good wrestling. Okay. 72%. Wow. It's a surprise. Hobbs wins. Wow, no. Oh, because fucking that dragged it the fuck down. Damn. Very good. Very good. Anyway. Now we get to go ahead a couple more days. I think, if I'm not mistaken, Okay. Thanks, Nixon. You're literally booking shows for me. Thank you. She's helping me so much. I'm happy she re-signed with WWE. Not gonna lie. If I have to go off on a tangent for a sec, I'm very happy that she signed with WWE. I'm happy they re-signed her. Okay, thanks, Hook. You guys are booking the shows for me, and I have to say thank you. So, the episode... First episode of May will feature Kiera Hogan versus Nixon Newell and Hook versus Ace Austin. Which, I guess only makes sense. I haven't really used Hook that much. So, it's current DPW Women's Champion Nixon Newell versus apparent current AEW Women's Champion Kiera Hogan. In a move that, god damn it, I don't really like, but it exists. And then we got Ace Austin versus Hook. And I'll give him 10 minutes because Hook asked. Because he asked for it. Other than that, I mean, yes, Tony Khan. Oh! I should see if I can put that in the soundboard thing with bits. I should see if I could do that. I think that'd be a fantastic idea. Let's run. Let's give Hobbs more to do, because I feel like I haven't really had Hobbs do a lot. Let's have him go up against Chris Masters, because why not? That seems like a fun time. And we'll have Fatu in action against, like, a speedball for, 10 minutes works. And then I'll do another interview with, that's the wrong place. Do an interview with, like, Like a Lee. Let's do Lee for 5 minutes for no reason other than I want to. It means I'll give Lee a match next week on the show. I'll have Nixon versus Hogan at the end. Yep, okay. Works for me. Mild interest. Woo! 80%. Hey, actual interest. Sort of interest. Actual interest in Kira Hogan won. Jesus Christ. Nixon is losing way too much for a champion. I'll admit that. Oh, no. No, don't leave. Don't re-sign Mr. Aldis. Why would you do that? Our popularity is already up at 70, goddamn. There you go, guys. Are you going to not say words? It's like, oh, there you go. Now I'm getting it. Oh, okay. I see what he's saying. Like, let me guess. I'm just like let me attempt to speak your language here. And we just both kind of look at each other, and he's just like silently nods. He's like, you're getting it. Just like, back to you guys at the desk. I should have saw that coming. Just like, did you really just try to interview? It's like, yeah, I don't know where I was going with that. I don't know why I thought that was a good idea, but I did. So shit happens. Okay, we're coming up on the contract. We're coming up on the expiries of Nixon and Bailey here. Which, Bailey in costing me $25,000 already kind of scares me for where it's going to be. Kind of scares me for where she's going to be when I try to bring her back. Actually, 67 star power. I might actually be able to bring her back for, like, relatively the same. Only 67 star power. Because star power is what drives it. Star power is absolutely what drives the cost of everything. So realistically, if I'm trying to get these girls back, it's gonna be paramount on me for their star power to be low, as shitty as that sounds. But the lower their star power, the less it costs me. So excuse me. Yeah. That. So I'm gonna run to the bathroom real quick, and we'll get back to booking more shows. Okay, I have returned. Okay, let's book these. Let's book more shows. I'll probably deal with extending I'll deal with extending these two after the next pay-per-view. Along with that, I'll also probably like start actually looking into signing more people on their permanent contracts. 14K. I mean, for a low important show, I mean, that's about normal. Oh, the best thing is it's a Sunday. It's a Saturday in June, so you know there's not a lot going on at the tank. And Saturdays in June. Actually, to be fair, no. I think hockey season would be over by then anyway. So, cool. I think the NHL season would just be over by then anyway. So, woohoo! I wouldn't have to worry about scheduling conflicts. Yay! All right, let's just gonna go with Brandy Cutler. You know what? I'm inclined to let that go. It's because it's stupid. Yeah, I mean that's how it goes. We'll do Dawson. No, we'll do, what the fuck is this? We'll just do Hobbs versus Romero. What the hell? We'll just do Will Hobbs and Rocky Romero in a match. For longer than that. There. Okay, this doesn't have to be 11 minutes. No. I mean... We'll auto do this. I mean, chances are they'll just have Bailey win it anyway. Dude, that's a pay-per-view worthy happening right there. That's what that is. If I need to fill an extra time on a pay-per-view, I'll do it. If I have like 5 minutes left on pay-per-view, I'll do it. Audience was into Hobbs versus Romero. What a surprise. Poor Nixon got pinned again. God, what the fuck? Wow. I think that was the first show I had that I lost popularity. God damn, that wasn't good. But then again, it's the first. It was the second show of the month. I can recover. I'll be fine. Okay. It's the first time I've had that happen. Gotta respond. With something other than fucking Fatu versus something other than Fatu versus Brandon Cutler. I think I will book... I'll book Dan Garcia at a match, though. Dan Garcia... I'll go with... Nemeth. And we'll go with... Yeah, Thatcher versus Romero again. Because it works. It always works. Hobbs versus King. Because yes, because we want it. And we'll do Bailey versus Nixon again. Can I have Nixon win this one, please? Because like she hasn't won very much recently. Oh, not for 1 minute. There, we'll do that. Speedball and Lee? That would that might be something to explore. Crowd lost interest, yay. Mild interest, yay. On their feet, yay. Like that. Actually into it, yay. Woo. Hey, I got that popularity right back. Let's go. Sold out the building. Let's go. We can take a look. It all depends on No, that's my roster. 53 star power skill. Probably not that much. Hey, it costs 30. Nope, that's too much. Nope, he costs 30. That's a lot. I was wrong, lol. Actually, how much would Bailey cost me now? Oh, fucking! You know what? We extended this bitch now. I'm capitalizing on this. Let's go. Same deal. Oh, of course they did. WWE made a counteroffer. Fuck you, you jackasses. Will you stop it? They're driving this up so much, bruh. Let's go. Okay, first of all, no, you're not gonna be that. Dude, they're like actually they're pricing me out here. We'll do three. And we'll try to bring this down a little bit. Fuck you guys. Man, I might not be able to make this happen. Cause this is essentially like doubling her wage. This is almost tripling her wage. Probably not a good idea, but I hate the Fed, man. If anything, I'm driving up the price for the Fed. So fucking. Okay, 3 years made event. Travel expenses isn't really that much of a big deal. Okay, so I've the Fed, man. Three more years, but at like what cost? At the cost of like 40k extra. Thanks, WWE. Also, this is just annoying to me. Travel expenses and no house shows for 67k. I realize I kind of got bingest here. 67, 930. That's a lot of money. Yeah, I mean it's not bad. It's really not bad. It could have been so much worse, but like, and I have her for three more years, so it could be so much worse. So much worse. You know what I should actually do? I should probably try to see if I can get the Fed to entice me to giving Nixon a little bit more, because I feel bad. Okay, good. She's already they've already said you're gonna have to give her a little bit more than that. Thank you. That was quick. I think I just gave her another year though. Yeah, it was only another year. I was gonna do it for three, but oh well. So they made me pay Nixon a little bit more too. Good. They maybe give Nixon a little bit more, which is fine. Let's just are just the smallest. I'm gonna just format these a little bit. There. Okay. Yeah. I mean, I can't say that I'm exactly happy with the fact that it cost me that much for Bailey, but I do have all this merchandising. I do have all this merchandising and shit for the next like 3 years. So It'll pay for itself, really. Let's be honest here. It'll pay for itself. Considering we've also got $40 million in the bank, I think we'll be okay. Right. I gotta start letting Willow Nightingale win more matches. Just to make everybody, just makes everybody happy. I mean, if I want Willow to beat somebody who's going to be okay with it. I mean, I have a feeling that Kylie Rae would be fine with it. She's just willing to. Yeah, she's just unbothered. As per her usual. Let's explore this Speedball Lee partnership. So you're probably not gonna have any problems with the Sharks unless they actually make the playoffs, which they won't. Hey, consider it's 2025, and actually, maybe they will. It's a couple years in the future. Maybe. Let's do. This is the only problem with having no tag division. I have an idea. We'll let him get some. We'll let him get some tag time. But just want to parachute this one in there again. I was going to say, I don't have a women's match on this card. Yes, I do. Let's have another then, shall we? Let's do Roxanne versus I don't know what I want to do for those last 10 minutes. We don't have Rick Knox refereeing anything. Let's let Rick Knox do this one. I just thought of something. Is Rod... Is he who I think he is? I need to... I'm gonna look something up really quick. See, oh my god. It is. Oh my god. This is an amazing discovery. Okay, so I need you to understand what I'm dealing with here. My family, on Fridays, always comes over, we have dinner, and we watch SmackDown. Always. Every week. Unless for some reason, we can't. So, we have a special... Like, sometimes we poke fun at the refs, obviously, as you do when you're watching with family. You just poke fun at the show. I need you to understand something. This referee on screen right here, Rod Zapata, we have my sister, I think, said that he looked like a discount Mike the Situation. So our little nickname for him is Mark the Circumstance. And I needed to make sure, because I just now got a good look at him and like, is that him? Ladies and gentlemen, I have hired Mark the Circumstance. I think I need to change his contract name to Mark the Circumstance. I think I need to do that. After the show, I'm going to do that. What a fucking coincidence that is, isn't it? Fucking fantastic. Let's do Kira Hogan and Brandi Loren is the ultimate, like, fucking, I need to fill, as the ultimate, fuck it, I need to fill 5 minutes match. Okay, yeah, we'll do the talking angle too, where I tell Lee and, I'll tell Lee and Speedball that they're tagging together. Lee and Speedball, 5 minutes. So yeah, I think that is fantastic. I just I needed to communicate that very quickly. Let me just make sure everything's good. It is. Okay. 69%. Yay, funny sex number. Oh, crowd lost interest. It's probably not a good sign, but I have an idea for the next pay-per-view anyway. Wow, crowd lost interest in this just absolute banger again. Really? I'm losing my popularity again, the fuck? That's not cool, bruh. Why? I don't like that. I have an idea for the next pay-per-view. Yeah, but, then again, who's, if I do that, who is Fatu gonna fucking defend against? I have an idea. I actually have an idea how he's gonna Speed Style. I like that name. I like that name. I'm registering them as a tag team in my thing with that now. I'm doing it now. I like that. Oh, I don't have him as a Speedball, Mike Bailey. It's just Mike Bailey. I like that. I like that a lot. I'm going to lean into my, I'm going to lean into my, I realize I didn't finish this thought. I'm going to lean into my relationship with PWG a little bit for this next show. And I have an idea. Might be crazy, but it's an idea nonetheless. Nice. Oh, they've lost a madcap. God damn. Okay. All right, so I have an idea for this. I'm going to stick in California for a little bit. I have a 20K seater for this next one, but, like, it's not close enough to it. So SAP's 18.3. Staples, I want to say, is... okay, Honda's 18.33. And Staples is... wherever the fuck Staples Center is 21, which is a lot. So I think I'm going to try to book this show for SAP Center again. Woot, we're going back to San Jose, baby. Silicon Valley Stupidity is also probably going to be in the Shark Tank too, but like, maybe not. We'll see how it goes. It's Silicon Valley Stupidity, so like, there's like two places I can book it realistically without pretending that I'm just at some random location. It's either SAP Center or it's fucking Levi Stadium, and I can't fill up Levi Stadium. Actually, I have Levi Stadium in here? I do. It's right here. That's us, baby. That's our kind of okay stadium. Oh, it's so great. Oh, let me just go ahead and add this in right now. Okay. So my idea was to have Fatu get inserted into this destined to do this forever with Rocky Romero and Timothy Thatcher in a triple threat match for... That's Jordan Grace. I need Fatu. Yeah, 75, yeah. You can go. Steal the show, obviously. For the DPW World Championship, it is... I can almost guarantee you that Fatu is going to lose it again. Yeah. And then for the match, tag teams, obviously we got Speed Style. Gonna just go ahead, grab a Mr. Brody King, go over to PWG, grab his boy, Malachi Black. But are we done yet? I wouldn't say that we're done yet, because there's one more team that I think could really make this one just a beautiful sight to behold. Oh, yeah. It's happening, boys. Oh, yeah. Steal the show, boys. Do the thing. I might make this the main event of the show. Even though there is a world championship to be defended, I think I'm gonna give that the main event, just because, you know, we know that one's gonna be at least interesting. Now, who am I gonna have? How many times has Bandito lost to Jordan Grace? I want to say it's been a couple times. Is it only once? No, twice. Was it only twice? Because if it was only twice, then he's had like three chances. I was gonna say, because if he had a third chance. I probably would have made him beat her for it. this next time just to be like, it's finally happened. I will have Bandito in a match though this week. I'll have him in a match against the Kratos man. Then we'll do, you know what? Let's do, let's do Speed Style versus Best Friends, because why not? We'll give him a little bit more tag experience. Then we'll do, oh, Fatu and Kratos. Right, I forgot about that. There's no way that Fatu is going to keep the belt after this match with the other two. So we can do that as like a mid-card kind of fuck it, why the hell not feud. Like, for no reason other than, yeah, sure, why not. Gresh, I want to have Jonathan Gresham on a show somewhere. We'll have him wrestle. Who's our best, like, wrestler, wrestling skill? Who's our best wrestler? It's Brody King. That is not who I would have guessed. Okay, fine. Sure, we can do that. Give him 15 minutes. Let's let him go. Then we'll let Simon Grimm have a match against JTG because I want to. Yeah, no, he's told me already, and it's pretty good. It's good stuff. Okay, yeah, this is fine. Losing interest, yay. Cool. See, we do enjoy this, and Speed Style wins again! Yay! We like when Speed Style wins their matches. Hey, selling out those arenas, yeah. Almost there. Oh, okay. Thanks, bro. Thanks for booking the show. Thanks for that. Thanks for giving me a match to book. Cool. Congrats. I'll even give you an extra 5 minutes just because you asked. Damn. I really lost my popularity that month. Wow. Ooh, when does the renegotiation window start? Next week. Okay. Yeah, next week after the next episode of DPW Fisticuffs, I am able to renegotiate my network deal. Woo! Honestly, I should probably look into a network deal that pays a little bit more per show. Maybe. I don't know. We'll cross that bridge when we get to it.
So Sky Blue have a match against Kylie Rae, because I've given you a match.
It's like, Kylie, I've given you a match against Sky Blue. Please win it. You haven't won in a long time. I'm giving you this match. It's about as quick, it's about as close to a freebie as I could possibly give you. Please win it. She then proceeds to not win the match. God damn it. Let's do Ace Austin. And hey, I think I ran Ace Austin, Dan Garcia this stream already. Let's do I almost clicked on Willow for X just reflexively. Versus Lee. In a 12-minute contest. Not for much longer, he isn't. He'll lose it to one of either Romero or Thatcher. There's no way he's gonna keep it. I think, have we done a litmus for this already? Have we done a litmus test to see if this would work already? We're gonna do it again. Yeah, this is fine. This is gonna be a bad show. This is gonna start the month off bad. Lance and Hawaii. Probably not. No. The only Lances that are here are Lance Storm and Lance Archer. Which, like, makes sense, honestly. Yeah, lost interest in Fatsy. Yeah, okay. Seemed to enjoy it. Cool. Yep, we're back to losing popularity already. Woohoo! Yeah, I knew that was going to be a bad one to start with. Seems about right. Lance and Jacob teamed while they were in. Right. Are you sure? I don't know, man. Maybe 10 minutes was a little too long. Maybe 10 minutes was a tad long. I mean, they're saying it, not me. You can't say, like, well, we're saying what you're thinking, which, like, true, but still. I'm like, well, that is true, but still. Did not establish number one contenders. Like I wanted to. Shit. Well, looks like I'm doing this on the fly then. I might just have Willow go up against Jordan Grace anyway for this one. I might. I think I will, actually. Jordan Grace. Willow Nightingale, DPW Twitch Championship. Wouldn't that be something? I'd fucking love that. Of all the people to dethrone Jordan Grace, it's fucking Willow. I would like that so very much. Give him 15 minutes. And for Nixon's opponent, we'll do another multi. Is she still? Yeah, she is. That I don't like that. I mean, I could, but, like, that's work. I could have Nixon. She's already defended against Bailey enough times. I could have Nixon go up against Yes, Marco Stunt. I gotta have Nixon go up against Athena. Actually, I was gonna have it be a multi-person match, but I think that would be fine on its own. Let's see if I can get away with this. Can I? Actually, no, let's do champions first. Nice. We have an extra 40 minutes to make up for this show. I'll figure something out. One thing I think I will figure out, though. Oh, yeah. It's happening. It's happening, baby. First ever for the inaugural DPW Tag Team Championships. I mean, I guess I can do that. I'm really just gonna auto-book this show. Okay, no, first of all. Oh, hey, look at that. They were gonna have them win. They're gonna have them win the night before the show. No, you can take that away, but, you can take that away, but, something in it. They're gonna be mad at me, because this is literally the match I was gonna have this was the match I was gonna have on the show before, this was the match I was gonna have on the show originally before I remembered, oh yeah, right, Athena exists. You know what, we'll just do automatic, I don't really care, 20 minutes is probably a lot. Marco and Kratos sounds like a pretty fun time. Probably. I didn't even realize that was the team. Fuck it. I don't really care if this show does well or not. I probably should, because it's like it's the go home show for next pay per view. I should probably care, but I don't. Is it? Okay. Seem to enjoy. Moments where the crowd lost interest. Oh, yeah. Kratos and boy. Yeah, that's it. All right. All right. Let's book the pay-per-view. Okay. Well, yeah. Okay. What do we got? Okay. JTG wants to work with Jake Crist. That's not going to make the pay-per-view, bruh. That's not how that's going to go. You can have your match with Jake Crist on the episode of Fisticuffs that's after. You can have the match with Jake Crist on the DPW Fisticuffs that's after. That is after. It's summer. Why is it still foggy? So, we have that penciled in already. Okay, let's finish this. Let's have Bailey do something. If only PWG had female wrestlers, and they don't. So, damn shame that. Anyway. We'll have Bailey do something with, who's the next highest on the totem pole? That's not her. So the upper mid card heel is it's Athena. So this would be the next logic. This would be the logical pairing. And we're not gonna have that go first. This is gonna go first. Always the one that starts off the show. And another 20-minute quiet. Let's do. It's probably not gonna be a 20-minute match. I probably shouldn't make it a 20-minute match. Is the real thing I should say. Realistically, that should kick off the show. Just get the one stinker out of the way first. Just get the fuck it, I'm out of ideas out of the way first. Then let's do. I don't like how he's enhancement talent. I mean, fucking hell. 85 wrestling skill, 88 stamina. God, he's like so good. I feel like he could have a good match with like pretty much anybody here. So I'm going to do that instead. I'm going to do this. For no reason other than I want to. Okay, after this, I'll go back and I'll start renegotiating my, because I think I can do that now. I can do this now, so I'm going to go, Yeah, I don't. Hold on. Oh. They're already telling me to fuck it. They're already telling me that they're going to up this shit like crazy. Fuck yeah, dude. They're going to up my pay from fucking 165 to 254. That's almost a 100k boost. Shit. I still want Thursday. I still want prime time. I want to go for a little bit longer than that. Let's go with that. Fuck yeah, baby. There we go. All right, so that's done. Now that's $254,100 per show now, which means I'm now making $1.1 million a month. On months I have five shows, it's make $1.1 million, which is pretty sweet. All right, that's that done. All right, let's get this done. I'll do the... Unless I feel like doing the... Nah, I'll do the next pay-per-view. I'll do the next pay-per-view deal after this one, because this is the last one that it's going to be under that umbrella. So let's just get this over with. In 10 minutes? Y'all are fucking... Y'all have no attention span. Jordan Grace wins again. I got to get this title off of her. Bayley wins against Kylie Rae in a 4-star contest. Obviously, Nixon beats Athena because I had it booked that way. Zack Sabre Jr. Really? Really? Fuck off, crowd lost interest. Get the hell out of here. Crowd lost. Oh my god, he defended it. Well, this is awkward. And the first ever DPW Tag Team Champions are because fuck you! It's because fuck you, because of course it is. God damn it. I tried speed style. I tried. The first ever DPW Twitch, the DPW Tag Champions is because fuck you. Damn, got pretty much everybody over huge except for Malachi Black. Damn. Did us numbers in Europe and Africa, but everywhere else is, yeah, that match absolutely fucked. So do we sign Jeff Cobb to a legitimate contract? I think we have to.
How much money did I just make off that show? How much money did I just make? Yeah, just casually another 8 mil on pay-per-view buys. Why is it still foggy to 518,965? So 518,965. Yeah, Yeah, I just made another $7 million on pay-per-view money. Yeah. We're doing good. And so for 4 show months, it's 860. It's still so much. It's still so much money. To the point where I really now don't have a I really shouldn't have any qualms now about about signing people to legitimate written contracts. God damn. Go ahead. I want to look through my my unreads really quick. I tried, guys. I tried. Yeah, with Jeff Cobb, I think we have to give him an actual contract now. I think we have to give him at least a PPA contract now. I think we have to. He's a tag team champion now. I feel like we have to. Okay, first it's not written. I won't do written. That's a lot of money for an appearance. Like a lot. He expects to be a main event good guy too. Oh, man, that's a lot of money. Oh, goodness gracious me. Well, then again, I was also probably going to sign Malachi Black, too, so... it's a lot of money, but I think I have to. All right, congratulations. He's the... Okay. No monthly pay, but I will give you a PPA. I'll let you be a main event heel right alongside Brody King. There. Okay, now we've got more, tag teams now. We have Because Fuck You, and then we have... I gotta change his name from Tommy N to Malachi Black and Brody King, Kings of the Black Throne. There you go. Yup, we have the sort of a tag division now. That tag division is costing me a lot of money, that's for sure. Alright, I gotta change his name to Malachi Black. Let me just do that before it escapes me. It's gonna fucking annoy me if it's not the same. They aren't, but... Yeah. Oh, right. I have to... I have to cancel the, Oh, yeah, right. I'm gonna change Rod Zapata to mark the circumstance. I have to. I can't just not do it. I can't not do it. I'm trying to think now. What was I going to do? Right. We will view other networks. So interested in networks, pay-per-view. It's AAA. It's triple. That's a AAA. What does this one have, actually? I don't. Bronze Live North America. This is the pay-per-view one? Oh, yeah, it is. Saturday, first of all. Probably that. Probably early evening. 24K. Yeah, no, I'd rather. No, I'd rather. I would rather look for another network that might pay a little bit extra for a new show. Let's just do North America for now. Pay per view only. America. Like cost per show only 12K. Like if I could. If 15 is a. Also, the moment when I realized that I could do this for every single region, like every single different region, I could have I could have a pay per view thing all on its own. If I were to do this, it still cost me 24K per show, and it's 15,000. For what if I were to do this? It's still an extra 24K, but 15 more. I mean, I don't really like the prospect of it costing 24,000 per show, but that's a 30K one. But it's also huge. We'll go with it when we'll start looking for other ones when the deal actually comes up. So it seems like these aren't really going to change much, if at all. So whatever. Then I guess I can just do the double. I can just do the double debutante. Yeah, let's do a double debutante match. We'll have a fuck it. Let's have both of you make your debuts at the same time. Then we'll do. As much as I really didn't want, I really didn't want to have Cobb and Hobbs be the first ever DPW tag team champions. It happened. I think actually I will say the thing that I wanted to happen even less was Fatu retaining his title. I'm not going to lie. I really didn't want it to happen. He's also running MLW too. Holy crap. He's a collector. He's a wrecking machine, this guy. He's a wrecking machine, Jacob Fatu. super low. What the hell?
It's weird. This will be towards the next show. It's happening, boys. The story is the story is unfolding now. I got a TV deal now. I got to be careful with medium risk stuff. Not entirely sure about 50 minutes with that, but we'll see. All right. Okay. Okay. Did a 3.3. We're almost at 50 mil in the bank. Too, so like that's good. Still absolutely friggin' destroying NXT UK though. Always a fun time. It's not that hard to destroy NXT UK though. What do we got? Girl. You know what? She wants to defend her championship again? Fuck it. Let's do it. We'll have her defend her championship again. All right. She wants to defend their title? Fine. You'll defend it again. Seems to me like she doesn't have a preference on her opponent. So, I get to pick it this time. Yes. If she doesn't care who she defends it against, fucking, we're doing this. She's not gonna win it, but. Wouldn't it be something if Willow won that match? I'd lose my marbles, dude. I'd lose my marbles. Let's do. I want to give Speed Style another go against Best Friends. Even though we did it already, I feel like I want to do it again. Just give him a little extra
a little extra trading with tag matches. Let's have... Actually... Let's further this just a little bit. Jordan Grace wrestle 2 against Roxanne.
NXT Women's Champion Roxanne. Sorry, I forgot to add her official title.
And then for the last 15 minutes, we'll do... Will Hobbs versus... We'll run Will Hobbs and Brody King back again, because we like it. Fun time! Except I will have Nixon and Willow in the main event, though.
Okay. Speed Style wins again in a 4.5-star match, just on merit alone. Damn. Heat that shit up just a little bit. 74% AE. Hobbs wins 80%. God damn. Wow, the worst segment of the night was the main event. God damn. That was a hell of a show. Holy crap. Yes. It did a 4.5 on TV. Shit. All right, there you go, Nixon. I got you. Don't worry. Hey, we've passed 50K. Let's go. We've passed 50 mil. Let's go. Okay. So the pay-per-view contract expires on the 12th. Yes. So I gotta renegotiate after that. I think that's probably what I'm gonna do last. If I had to guess, it's probably what I'm going to do last. Then we might move into Stream Racer if I feel like it. Come Tuesday, stays put. Okay. So yeah, after this next episode of DPW Fisticuffs, then we will start negotiating with other networks to do pay-per-view stuff. And we'll actually do it for all 6 regions. We won't just keep it to 1. Oh, this distribution shit is gonna pop the fuck off. Excuse me. I haven't done much with Hook in a while, and I don't. Has AEW been doing stuff with Hook? Yeah, AEW has done some things with Hook. Not a lot of things, but some things. I'm gonna do some stuff with Hook. Let's do Hook, and let's do it with. Because we'll give him like 5 minutes. Then, has AEW been using Marco Stunt at all? That's what I want to know. No, not really. Biggs responded.
fucking... You right. Let's do... You right. Chris Masters and Ace Austin. Maybe not 15 minutes. And we'll do story beat. Interviewer obviously is going to be me. And I'm going to interview a certain world champion. I'm going to interview a certain world champion about attacking a certain other person backstage. And then I will have Kylie Rae do a match, because she hasn't been in one of those in a while. We will have her go up against... I already know for a fact, if I do this, and I just leave it up to the computer, it's going to make Brandi Loren win. I'm going to make Kylie Rae win, because, you know, she hasn't won a match in seemingly forever. So... I'm honestly surprised she didn't pinch a bitch fit when I said, hey, you're losing this match. It's not normally how it goes. Bandido will take on... Have I made him go up against Lee yet? I think I will. In a match that I think would absolutely fuck if they gave it a chance. Last 15 minutes. We'll do Thatcher versus Malakai Black. Might look into that. All right. This should be a show. Mild interest in parts. Yay! Seemed to enjoy. Decent enough angle. Heats shit up. Kylie Rae finally won a match. Lee and Bandido kind of did a good thing. And Malakai Black and Timothy Thatcher did a great thing. Fun times. No shift in popularity, but you know what? We good. Okay. What do we got? Okay, so Thatcher wants to... Oh, that's interesting. We'll do that. He's in the middle of a story, but honestly, we can do that. We'll have... Yeah, we can have Thatcher and Kratos happen. Give him 10 or so minutes. At an angle where Fatu comes out and beats him up a little bit after the match. For reasons of because why the hell not? Because I like hitting you. Then we'll give Kiera Hogan a match against NXT Women's Champion Roxanne. And we'll do Nemeth versus
JTG, which I haven't done in a while. Give that one 10. And then we'll have... Lee and Speedball versus... Dawson and... Let's go with... Sure, I guess. Get in some more tag reps. And we'll do Ace Austin and Bandido for a 10-minute contest. Honestly, this is a very weird show. Honestly, it's whatever. Mild interest in parts. Love it. Fatu does his thing. Okay. Speed Style wins again. And Bandido wins the main event in probably the weirdest show that I've booked for this promotion yet. Alright. And the TV deal has... the pay-per-view deal has now... ended. So the pay-per-view deal is now over. I mean, at least I think it's over. Okay, no, I don't want to book that far ahead. I think I should probably have an email that says, hey, these are... No, never mind. And it's... Actually, once I sim ahead one more day, it'll... Once I sim ahead one more day, it'll be over. Okay. Partnerships are over. The pay-per-view is over. That means that my pay-per-views now have no distribution. Partnerships are over. Okay, so I think it'll already start. The new one will start already. If it doesn't, I just got to remember it's KVPX North America. The Fisticuffs deal. All of a sudden, I got a massive urge on me. Okay, I'll just keep that there. Okay. So, for networks, pay-per-view networks right off the bat, I think I was going to go with... Okay, let's start with just North America. I think I was going to start with this one. It's already got a deal. I think I was probably going to go with one of these two, then. They're probably the same exact thing. Unless, no, okay, so NXT already has that one. WWE already has that one. So I'm bound to the like larger networks. So like one of these two, it's essentially the deal that I have now. Yeah, they're essentially the deal. Yeah, they're essentially the deal that I have now, which is the problem. I mean, I can go with this, but like it's the same day that I want, so. It's the same time that I want, so, I'll probably go with one of these two then. It really doesn't matter, because they're the exact same thing. It's just in name. So let's do, I mean, it really doesn't matter. I could literally flip a coin and it wouldn't matter. Yeah, I'm gonna do that then.
Heads, cool. We're going with this one. Negotiate. Let's get this for 3. Monthly annual premium events. Okay, let's do that. That's for PLEs. Ah, crap. I didn't. Oh, right. You can't change these. You can't change these ones to be away from Monday for some fucking weird reason. Let's do pay-per-views. Let's do a South America one now. What is available for South America? Fan Fight pay-per-view. South America has a huge one that's available. And so it's this one, too. I mean, honestly, it doesn't really matter. I think I'll, again, it doesn't really matter. I think I want to go with one of these two because it's going to cost more per show, but I think there'll be more exposure. Tails, we're going with Fighter Box Office, South America. Let's try to get it for 3 years, $15 per. There we go. That's, now let's move on to Asia. Pay-per-view only. Okay, obviously we've got... Okay, Infinite Pay-per-view. Of course, it's got NXT. So it's either Infinite Pay-per-view Asia or Emerald Premium Asia. Because I don't think... Oh, we actually have this one. We have this one as a huge option. I think I'm going to go with this. So obviously, again, for 3 years, it's gonna take a considerable chunk out of our reserve. But honestly, it's fine. Gold Premium Europe. Okay, cool. We've already got a huge one here. So yeah, Gold Premium. I assume it's going to be Gold Premium Europe. Yes. Okay, we'll negotiate with that. Obviously, we want all of them. 3 years. And then we'll... Even though Africa is probably going to be a little fickle, there's probably no... Oh, Entertainment Network Africa. Cool, we'll go with that. Yes, we're going to do the streaming. Oh, 100%, yeah. Yeah, we're going to be making... Hopefully, we're going to be making a lot of money with this. And Oceania for the Aussie boys. Fighter Pay-Per-View Australia, obviously. Oceania. Fireworks Box Office or Metal Box Office. Do I want fireworks or do I want metal, boys? It really doesn't matter. They're both huge. They're both huge in size and average in library. Minimum viewership, 59K. Wow, okay. It doesn't really matter. I want this one. It'll only cost me 4K per show. Damn, okay. For, so 30, so... I'm gonna have to do another one of these columns for, I'm going to have to do another one of these columns for, okay, so the total for total cost now, region cost, NA, LA, EU, AS, AF, and OC. So we've got... 24K per show in North America. I think it's also 24K per show. It's 30K per show in Latin America. 30K per show in Asia. $30K per show in Europe. Africa is another 30K one, and Oceania is only 4,000. So now we just we grab the sum from M3 to M8. Yeah, I mean, with the way things are going already, shit. Oh my god. If we're going to be making $15 per buy on all of these. Shit. Oh my god. If we're going to be making Oh my goodness. If that's how it works, Bobcat, we're going to be making more than 25 mil per show. Remember when I said a couple streams ago that these network deals are fucking busted? These network deals are busted. These network deals are fucking busted. Like, oh my god, I might need to get into, I might need to, because I'm on, because with another one, on my alt Discord account, I'm on the Pro Wrestling Sim Discord, and I'm going to be like, one of my ideas is that y'all might need to dial back these network deals, because they're way too powerful. Like, these network deals are so powerful. Like, I make 46,000, I have a fucking potential to make $46 million per pay-per-view. I think I'm gonna make Thatcher Fatu's next opponent. Just because it's right there. I might as well do it. Hey man, when I'm not playing as the WWE, is good numbers. It's like, also, I'd like to just point out, I don't play as the WWE when I play this game. So, like, I don't play as the WWE when I play this. So, it's obviously, like, a lot more difficult for me to make, like, huge, huge ad numbers. Ooh, I gotta renegotiate Athena's contract. That would be a good thing to do. Let's book a couple more shows. I'll deal with that, and then we'll be good to go here. It just goes to show you, man. I know what I'm doing. I haven't let Bailey do anything in a while. Bailey will take on NXT Women's Champion Roxanne. Lucky number 13 minutes. And then we'll have the tag team champions in action against the best friends. Because I want this. Actually, I wonder, hold on. Do they have... Oh, they don't have Best Friends with Orange Cassidy as a stable. Let's do... Nemeth versus somebody from PWG. Robbie Eagles. Because why not? I mean, it probably wouldn't. I definitely feel like I could get away with it now. And then, we'll do... Have I done Dan Garcia and Ace Austin yet? I might have. Hold on, let me check that. Have I... Ace Austin, Bandito, Chris, Ace Austin, Lee Moriarty, Ace Austin, and Hook. I've done it with Hook, not Dan Garcia. So yeah, let's do it with Hook then. No, not Hook. Let's do it with Dan Garcia then. Give him 10 minutes to go. Add the match, and then we will. Oh. I'm going to have to make Timothy Thatcher have his match prior to
I'm going to have to make Thatcher have his match prior to Silicon Valley Stupidity, because I completely, it slipped my mind that Fatu and Kratos had their feud. And it's going to be the blow off. So and for the main event, we'll do Simon Grimm and Lee with Speedball in his corner. Yeah. 66%, 69%, 77%, hey, 64%, and 70%. Not good enough for any change, but you know what? This is a good show to me. I mean, when we're doing 3.8s on TV, making 250K in ticket sales and in the TV deal, we're making 500K an episode of... We're making 500K for every episode of DPW Fisticuffs, so fucking... That's good. The only thing is I have no distribution for Fisticuffs outside of the States, so, like, I 100% could... Do that too. You know what? If you win this match, I'll extend you. I mean, I'm probably gonna extend her anyway, but I really don't wanna have Athena just like as a fucking cup of coffee stop here. Like, I really don't. I wanna keep her around, but like 13, we'll give you the extra minute. Honestly, right before I go in, I might check and be like, who is available that I could justify bringing in over her. Beautiful. Let's do Willow versus Jordan Grace again, because I want it. Then we'll do we'll have Kratos fight Dan Garcia. Fatu run interference. Then I'm gonna have Bandito do a thing against, yeah. Why are you there? Stop being there. Puma King versus Bandito. Absolute banger of a match, that. And for the last 12 minutes, we'll do... This is a very female-dominated show, now that I'm looking at it. We'll do NXT Women's Champion Roxanne and Bayley, because why not? I'm paying her, so... I still think I'm going to go with Puma King and Bandito as the main event. Question! Let me just check one thing really fast. She's still the Women of Honor? Yes, she is. I fucking... Can you please, like, make her drop it, bro? Carrie Silken, I'm asking you to please make Roxanne drop the belt. Please. So as soon as she does, I can snap her up and sign her, so she will be all mine. All right, let's book the show. Then I'll renegotiate with Athena. Jordan Grace beats Willow. Kratos beat Garcia despite Fatu running interference. And Bayley beats Roxanne. And Bandido beat Puma King. Doing all right. Okay, so... Oh, I can actually... Okay. Oh, still has extra time, that's why. Okay, so... Promises to Athena have been... All right, let's see. 6K on pay. She's already upper mid-card heel. Let's see if I can get her for another three. Three, let's see. Please don't make any count. Please don't have WWE make counter offers. I hate you. We're really doing this again. God damn it. I hate the Fed. I hate the Fed in this game so fucking much. Really? I hate the Fed. Okay, cool. They just fucking... It wasn't nearly as bad as it was with Bayley, but it still wasn't ideal. It was like 6K when it started. It was like 6K when it started. Now, fucking... It's just annoying. Stupid Fed. Okay, we'll just have that. Stupid Fed. Okay, let's take one check on the morale. Everything seems to be fine. The only thing that sucks is a Kristen Marco stunt is the only seemingly off thing. Other than that, everything is fine. I think we're good for today, actually. We've done pretty much everything, so, if I were to do Stream Racer, would people stick around for that, or would people go? Because I'd be willing to do a couple of those. I'd be willing to do a couple races of that. All right. Guess who's got the fucking Twitch championship? Guess who's got a Twitch championship match coming up in 5 days? Guess who's gonna lose that Twitch championship match in 5 days? It's like, I don't care, you're losing. It's like, I don't care, you're losing. The simulation might give you the fucking Gluck Gluck 9000, but not me. I ain't doing that. And so it is a triple threat. I very easily could just be like, no, get the hell out of here. And so it is a triple threat match. Let's just go ahead and earmark this for next time. It's going to be the weirdest, definitely the weirdest match we've ever had. Jordynne Grace versus Brandi Loren and Bhupinder Gujjar. For the DPW Twitch Championship, I'm giving you 7 minutes, and Jordynne Grace is retaining it. She's retaining it, and we're making her look good. I'm sorry, this is how it's happening. That is how it is happening. You get no time whatsoever. Because this is just stupid. Okay, so we've made more progress today. A lot more progress today. If I may for one sec, it is dark. There we go. So we've made progress today. I think this is where we part for today. I will be back on Saturday. I'll probably do the Stream Racer stream on Saturday. So be around for that.
Be ready to watch some cars go speed. I will see you guys when that happens. Bye-bye.